So we have our trench for the bottom drain pulled all the way over here to where our settlement tank is gonna be. Now remember, that trench is perfectly level across the pond's floor. We've tunneled under the bond beam. We've tunneled all the way over here to where our settlement tank is. Now our settlement tank is gonna sit taller than the plumbing that's coming from the bottom drain since we're so deep, but we're gonna put some sweeping 90s in and we're gonna install a knife valve for servicing. And at this point, I wanna go ahead and explain to you a little bit more about the purpose of the settlement tank. The job of the settlement tank is to capture all the debris and fish waste that comes in through the bottom drain. Now, this is a gravity flow settlement tank, which means we're not gonna take a pump and hook it directly to the bottom drain. We're gonna take the pump and connect it to here and have the bottom drain connect to here at the same time. Now, when we pull water from this settlement tank, the water, of course, is gonna start to lower inside here, but since the bottom drain is connected into it as well, then water from the pond is gonna balance it out and push water into this, and that's gonna happen through our 4-inch pipe. Now, a lot of people are gonna wonder why we're using such a big pipe. We're gonna use a 2-inch pipe to pull water out of here at a high velocity, and we're gonna use the 4-inch pipe to bring the water back in, so that way the debris and the fish waste moves along the pathway a lot slower so it doesn't get broken up and go and clog up our biological filter. Now, once we have the settlement tank set, we will have this basket in place connected to the bottom, and our water is gonna travel out to the pump through this basket here. So it's gonna be setting in here, and this water is gonna be pulling from the upper area of here, and our bottom drain inlet's gonna come in lower than this. So the heavier solids are gonna settle to the bottom of the tank. Now the neutrally buoyant solids that are kind of suspended and floating around will get trapped inside these shavings, because we'll open these bags up and we'll place these shavings around that suction port, and then this will sit there and capture everything until it's time for cleaning. So to get this thing plumbed up, I wanna point out a couple things. This particular unit gives us a lot of different flat spots, so it gives us a lot of options on where we wanna do our plumbing. One option that I wanna point out right away is this mouse hole right here. This is where our suction port is that we're gonna connect our pump to, and it pops through here in the bottom. You can see we have a bulkhead in here already installed. So I'm gonna plumb this out, but I wanna point this mouse hole towards the trench that leads to our life support station. And that, of course, leaves this pointing towards the pond. And so my bottom drain is gonna punch in right here. So let's go ahead and get this thing started. So we just wanna follow our typical plumbing protocol. I'm gonna put some Teflon tape on this male pipe adapter. And of course, glue and primer and all that good stuff. But we'll walk you through the bottom of this guy because it's gonna be hidden as soon as I bury it. So I got that pushed in, and I'll hold it. Let it harden off just a second. Now I could sweep my pipe right into here, but it proves to be a little bit of a challenge. So what I often like to do on this particular unit, I'll either put a coupling on here, and I'll run my pipe right into that, or I might even sweep a 45 on this particular one as my trench drops into here. But this thing's ready to set now. On the ground, but I want to plumb the bottom drain in first.